Every rock on Earth is composed of minerals, with there being a very wide range of compounds and native elements. Since there are currently 6,031 known minerals, some are more common while others are less common. So, which mineral is the most common to be found by volume in Earth? It turns out to be a mineral that, despite being so common, the vast majority of the world's population has never seen it. I am not referring to quartz, the form of silicon dioxide which comprises 12% of Earth's crust, and I am not referring to the feldspar group of minerals which comprises 51% of Earth's crust. Instead, I am referring to the mineral bridgmanite, which by volume comprises 38% of our planet. This means that 2.26996 trillion metric tons of bridgmanite exists on Earth, so why did it take until 2014 for this mineral to be discovered? The answer is that bridgmanite is the primary constituent of Earth's lower mantle, which is so deep that its minerals essentially cannot be directly observed by scientists, specifically at between 660 and 2900 kilometers or 410 to 1802 miles depth. At these depths, bridgmanite comprises 75% of the mantle, with the other two primary minerals present being ferropericles and perovskite in decreasing abundances. Before I describe how this absurdly common mineral formed, I want to elaborate on why it took until 2014 to be discovered. For context, minerals in the very top portion of the upper mantle, such as olivine, are somewhat commonly brought to the surface via the upward motion of magma, which results in volcanic eruptions, with an example of this occurring 580,000 years ago in Arizona's extinct San Carlos volcanic field. This emplaced what is today sourced as 90% of the world's peridot. Olivine is fairly common and stable at the very top of the mantle, which can be as little as 5 kilometers depth all the way to 410 kilometers depth, with most of this peridot in the San Carlos field originating in the upper mantle's uppermost section. To get minerals which occur deeper in the mantle, you generally need kimberlite pipes which not only transfer diamonds in place to 150 to 200 kilometers depth to the surface from the thick lithosphere of cratons, but can also sometimes even transfer amounts of olivine's deeper cousin, wadleysite, at 410 to 520 kilometers depth, or ringwoodite at 520 to 660 kilometers depth. The reason the same chemical formula forms different minerals at increasing depth relates to the extreme pressure and heat rearranging atoms into the most stable arrangement at those conditions. As for bridgmanite, it forms due to the decomposition of the mineral ringwoodite into the minerals bridgmanite and ferropericles at 660 to 2900 kilometers depth, with a melting point of 2780 to 5330 degrees Celsius. Depending on pressure the mineral experiences, it does not melt in even the lowermost mantle, where temperatures reach 3700 degrees Celsius. Bringing lower mantle minerals to the surface is near impossible except for one very infrequent circumstance, meaning that to understand what our planet's lower mantle and core are composed of, we need to turn to a completely separate group of astronomical bodies. Asteroids. Asteroids represent material left over from the formation of our solar system, with some fragments representing what was once the mantle or core of a long ago destroyed protoplanet. While this is an extreme oversimplification, chondrites can represent the crust, halicites can represent the mantle, and iron-nickel meteorites can represent the core of differentiated asteroids, where denser materials sunk into the core and lighter materials rose towards the surface. You might thus think that a specimen of bridgmanite was found in a palisite or iron-nickel meteorite, but instead it was found in a chondrite meteorite which fell to Earth in Australia in 1879. While this class L6 chondrite would ordinarily not have contained the very high-pressure mineral bridgmanite, it did because long ago it experienced shock metamorphism from asteroid impacts which created small amounts of this mineral. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's new patron, TW Corey, for supporting this channel.